was surprisingly reasonable.
Okay, so Swift, I think questions have given us max, go from zero to max. I don't know if that's his preferred answer, but I think it seems like it should be on that for now.
Oh, it's you. Out late again, I see. What brings you here? I just wanted some fresh air. There's a lovely breeze tonight. I always wander outside when sleep evades me. So I see. Still, it's ill-advised to stay up so late. I should get some sleep too, but... Have you ever felt a sort of longing for the outdoors? I have. There are times I long for the warmth of the sun, for a sweet breeze on my face. Do you remember what I told you the other night? About my past? None of my siblings had a chance to lead the sort of life they deserved. An ordinary life. My siblings and I were... We were imprisoned underground, beneath the palace. The objective was to endow our bodies with the power of a major crest. I have always possessed the crest of Saros, inherited through the Hresfeld bloodline. But it was only a minor crest, and most of my siblings bore no crest at all. In order to create a peerless emperor to rule Fodlan, they violated our bodies by cutting open our very flesh. Now here I stand, the fruit of that endeavor, Edelgard von Hresfeld. But that came at too high a price. The others were sacrificed. Ours weren't the only lives devastated by that terrible process. Innocents died as well, without even knowing what they were dying for. And there you have it, the truth of the Hresfeld's empire. Prime Minister and his gaggle of nobles. They had the Empire under their thumbs. My father, the Emperor, tried to stop him, but it was futile. My father was nothing but a puppet on a string by then. He was powerless to save us. I know how it all sounds, but when you see my true strength, you will know I speak the truth. I have kept it hidden all this time, but I will reveal to you the power of my second crest. It is the same as yours, the Crest of Flames. When it manifested for me, I swore a silent oath. For the sake of my family, and for all the poor souls whose lives were traded for my existence, for their sake, I will build a world where such meaningless sacrifices never again sanctioned. As Emperor, I will change the world. I swear it.
Wow, it's only...
I am ready to begin.
Oh, and I decided to do that too.
We will work with each other.
Obvious.
We had a great result.
How do they get stones from doing that, though?
I see now.
Grander, I still don't know what that is. I guess at some point I should try. I trust you don't need to be a bee with that. But you do have a lot of... Oh, he gave it to... Okay, he has a skill that possess. Let's see. Rings 2. To come. Alright, we're going to battle. Paralog battles branch away from those inside stories. So Paralog's victory in this branch out of the castle. Go ahead and do that one. Okay, so since this fight should be pretty easy, this is fine. Well, not much. This attack. Let's go.
me in there.
I will prevail.
Stay focused.
I will get the victory. Oh no.
As you wish.
I owe you one.
For Lady Edelgard.
I kept pressing right now.
Suffice? You are nuts.
A great help. Brother will be pleased. I understand more every day.
Oh,
defeat was inevitable.
Seems more like you that. Let's see what actually happens.
How lovely. Least I could do. Failure is not an option. Appreciate it. Why, thank you. Did that suffice? I feel my strength building.
I thank you.
There's a good chance of that.
How lovely.
Thank you.
least I could do.
I guess the only reason I'm trying to reach the ranks is because he might be a not a wyvern, but keep saying.
Excuse me, Professor. May I have a moment of your time?
This is somewhat fast, I think.
Ah, wonderful. I was hoping you might enlighten me. About yourself, that is. You see, I happen to be quite curious about you. Well, because there is something different about you. You possess an air of mystery. I could not help but notice when first we met. I am intrigued, to say the least. I find it rather difficult to put into words. Were I to wax poetic, I would say you remind me of the sea. Have you ever been, Professor? The sea is vast, boundless. On the surface, all seems still. Yet beneath that stillness, it is unfathomably deep. Within, it teems with life. Yet without, one is lucky to glimpse a fleeting shadow. And yet, all one must do is cast a line to grasp hold of all that life. You cannot see it at a glance, but it is there all the same.
That's deep, man.
About fish, of course. Oh, bother. I got sidetracked, didn't I? Right. About the sea. During a storm, the once calm waters become mighty enough to overturn even the fastest ships. Not unlike you. You are calm. You carry yourself with poise. Yet you wield great power. My brother was uncertain of you at first. He once referred to you as a youth of dubious origin. Oh, but please do not think ill of him. He is incredibly dedicated to his work. So surely you understand why he would have doubts about one of whom he knows so little. Nobody even seems to know your age. Incidentally, how old are you?
I don't know.
Wait, you do not know your own age? You truly are mysterious. Looking at you, it is quite difficult for me to determine. I wonder, could you be younger than your own students?
I don't think that.
Who? Me? Well, I am roughly the same age as the other youths here. Be that as it may, it is simply not the case.
Say so.
Oh, by the way, you should know I had actually been considering enrolling in the academy for a while. I have endured hard times, but I am so grateful that those very experiences led to my acceptance at the academy. Oh, my apologies. I am sure you have much work to do. I will not keep you any longer. We must speak again sometime, if that would be all right. Have a lovely day.
I won't forget all I've learned.
How long will this take?
Let's see.
Well done. You have my thanks.
I can't believe it. How can I show my face to Lady Edelgard after this?
That's what you get, Hubert. If you rested like me, you wouldn't collapse from exhaustion.
As much as it pains me to say, you're right. But to be looked after, by you of all people, that might be the worst part of this. I don't know how to feel, to be honest. So for now, let's pretend I thanked you.
Oh, come now. Even I wouldn't abandon someone who collapsed.
You would have in a heartbeat if anyone else had been around.
Ah, yes. Quite accurate, Hubert. Why would I ever bother to be a decent person if there were anyone else I could foist the duty upon? If your situation turned bad, it would have been an absolute hassle. I could never just leave you there.
If that were the sort of man you truly were, we could never be friends.
But if we weren't friends, I probably would have just left you.
Shame you're so reluctant to do any real work. You're actually pretty good at this. Made sure I was comfortable, checked carefully for injuries, even carried me here yourself. If only you'd apply that knowledge of yours so proactively and thoroughly all the time, you'd be a tremendous asset to the Empire.
There you go again. I see no problem with staying just the way I am. Think of it this way. In an anthill, 20% of the ants are asleep at any given time. And it's not because they're lazy. Far from it. When the working ants become tired, they go to sleep and the others wake up. That's me. I'm the ant who rests so I can work later when other people are tired.
Maybe that's true. But even if it is, it's still just a fancy way to say you let others do all the work. Consider me unconvinced.
I'll consider you a bother and leave it at that. You and Edelgard work far too hard. I mean it. Take a break now and then. If you both collapsed, I think it'd be too much effort for me to bother with. Get some rest, Hubert. Not as much as me, of course.
Fine.